So I'm starting with the code we had before that works correctly, except for with this assumption that all months have 30 days. So the first step is going to be to define a stub procedure, days and month, that gives the number of days in a month. But for our stub procedure, we're just going to always return 30. And I'm going to modify next day to call days and month. That's pretty simple, but I should start testing. And I'm going to write some code to do testing. We don't want to have to keep typing the same test cases in the shell. We want to write some code for testing. For the problem as provided, there were some provided test cases. I'm going to write my own starting now. And I'm going to make sure that now these test cases, we don't expect the correct results yet because I'm testing with 30-day months. So I'm going to test two dates that are the same. It's a boundary case. It's a useful one to test. I'm going to test from one day to the next. That should give us one day. And these are test cases for days between dates. I should really be writing some test cases for next day. The reason for that is that if they fail, well, it's going to be more easy to understand what went wrong rather than just writing all of my test cases for days between dates. So let's try some next day test cases. I've got one where the day advances. Let's get one where the month advances. And I will use a month that has 30 days. So it will be correct in 30-day months, but we'll still be correct once we fix this. And I'll use advancing the year. A few test cases. Probably we should have more, but let's try that. We should save, and let's run this, and we'll run our test. And something failed. Not too surprising. This happens. Let's see what failed. And the failure is a type error that I'm calling days and month, not passing in the right number of parameters. In fact, I passed in 0. I should have passed in both the year and the month. So this is one of the reasons for writing things in stubs. We can find these kinds of errors quickly. So let's try again. And now our test passed. And our test case is using assertions. I'm going to be a little more careful and print something out when the test finishes, because it's a little bit dangerous to have nothing tell us when the test finished. Maybe we didn't get any output for some other reason.